What's going on, folks? My name's Stephen Wolf. A little while back, a friend of mine's birthday came up, and as a bit of a gift, I was like, hey dude, let me paint some figures for you. He's a huge fan of DC Comics, so I hit up Wayland Games, and I managed to get a really cool Darkseid figure and a really cool Superman figure. It looks fantastic, but you might notice a little problem with this particular figure. The head is miscast. Luckily, I contacted the seller, and they were like, oh, goodness, well, can you send us pictures? Send them the pictures, and thank goodness, they were able to replace it. But what to do with the miscast Superman? Do I just throw him in a bits bin, call it a day? Sell him to someone else who doesn't know any better? Nah. No. That would be a disservice. So let's get to work. One of the initial important steps that I had to do was clean up any and all of the seams on this figure. Not only was the cast an issue, there were some really gnarly seams on this figure. I cut it out to save some time. I'm actually using a Tamiya modeling putty that's normally used for plastic miniatures because of the way it can fuse to the plastic. However, this stuff is just as useful for metal figures, so don't let the name fool you. It's actually some really quality stuff. I was being a bit of a bum here, using my fingers instead of using, say, a toothpick. So I'm doing the intelligent thing of using a toothpick. Luckily, though, it ended up looking okay. My primary goal was twofold. Proof of concept that it could be done, that a plastic... There we go. Now I spot, hey, I should use the toothpick. Brilliant, Steve. Brilliant. Took me long enough, jeez. But my initial goal was twofold. First, the idea was, can this be done? Can I use a plastic modeling putty to repair a metal figure? And second, could I make it look like nothing had happened to the figure, like this was the way the figure was initially advertised? Luckily, things went pretty well. I let the putty dry for a couple of days, just to be on the safe side, which is why there's parts for a different model kit in the background. You'll see that video later on, promise. Not gonna lie, I got extremely lucky with the way I applied the putty to the character. It ended up drying in a perfect pattern. The hairline lined up perfectly with the new hairline lined up perfectly with the original sculpted hairline, and then after a quick spritz of Mechanicus Standard Gray, he was ready for painting. First and foremost was getting the jumpsuit and cape the colors that I wanted. I ended up going with a Latok blue for the main body, and went with a regular classic corn red. The reason I chose the color palettes was I knew the washes would darken them a bit as I progressed, but also I wanted it to look like the Kingdom Come Superman outfit that Brandon Routh is going to be wearing for the CW's Crisis on Infinite Earths. I really love the way the outfit looks. It looks very close to Alex Ross's original artwork. Absolutely fantastic. And he gets to play Superman again, so, you know, who can really complain? Next up, for all the red parts of the apparel, I went with corn red, as I described earlier. I actually wanted to try something a little bit different today. Normally, I would use some type of brown or black wash, but since the figure wasn't going to a customer or to anyone other than a shelf in my room, and I would be the only one stuck looking at it, I decided to experiment with washes. I ended up going with Drakenhof Nightshade for all the blue parts, and Carolberg Crimson for all the red parts. This actually turned out to be pretty darn cool, as it stuck to the details surprisingly well. It really added some nice 3D texturing to it. It really made some of those hard edges pop. After doing a bit of cleanup work, I decided to move on to some of the black detailing for the character. One of the unique things about the Kingdom Come Superman outfit is, rather than having yellow on the inside of the chest emblem, it's black. Also, instead of having yellow on the belt, he has a black belt with a metallic buckle. I did experiment a little bit with a black rim on the boots just to see how it looked, but I ended up changing my mind afterwards during the cleanup process. It's not at all uncommon to have an idea while you're painting a figure, and then having to change it later on when you realize, wow, this looks like trash. That's something you're actually going to see pretty early on in my next video, but I can go into detail a little bit right now. I do enjoy the creative process of painting miniatures and coming up with new and exciting art styles for different characters, and it's never a bad thing, as long as it's not like a customer's figure. It's never a bad thing to experiment with different paint schemes or different designs. For example, the rim of the boots. Like, well, how would this look if there's a black rim on the boots to differentiate the red from the blue? And after a little bit of effort, it's like, no, that actually doesn't really work with the rest of the art style. There's a rim built onto it, sure, but it's more of a detailing in the leather rather than something that should be defined. Restating the obvious, but yeah, it's never a bad thing to experiment, just so long as you're having fun doing it and you end up enjoying the final product. Next up was a pretty obvious choice. Cadian flesh tone with a little bit of Reichland flesh shade to really bring out those awesome details. I actually made a mistake pretty early on of not paying attention to where the hairline was, but luckily I was able to fix it. One of the unique things about the Kingdom Come Superman character is that he's actually started to go gray. He's kind of got a Mr. Fantastic thing going on with gray on the sides connecting to the back on his hairline. It actually adds a lot to the character. It definitely makes him look much older, much more venerable. This is not the Superman we grew up on. This is a man who's existed for quite a long time. He's seen a lot of people, close friends, pass of old age, whereas he's been relatively unchanged. It's quite a sobering take on such a popular character. One last step before we get to applying the washes is figuring out the different shades of blue that I should probably use for the base. One of the things that kind of irked my nerves was that the Superman figure came on this really awesome base that clearly shows him in the Fortress of Solitude, whereas the Darkseid character, he's just standing there looking ominous as all heck. So I was trying to figure out different ways that I could finagle the blue to look right. I ended up applying a Corax white to some of the highlight areas, and then just soaking the base area with that Carolberg crimson again. From there, it was applying the flesh tone, Reichland flesh shade, as I mentioned before, Carolberg crimson for the cape, and Drakenhof nightshade for the blue. I had to let it dry for a while, just to make sure all the different parts looked proper. I ended up having to dry brush different varying amounts of blue back onto the character. Some of the details didn't look right after the way I washed it, but after a lot of effort and a little bit of cleanup, the figure looked fantastic. I'm very happy with my repair efforts. I was a little concerned at first as to whether or not I'd be able to complete the repairs, but thankfully, I didn't have to make that decision on a customer's figure. I'd like to thank my parents in this video. not only for putting up with me for the past 26 years and counting, but also for those absolutely fantastic photos shown in the video. By the way, those photos will be shared on my Facebook page, Stephen Wolf Custom Figures. I'm pretty sure I'll be able to have a link in the description down below. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and hit like and subscribe and ring the bell for notifications, because YouTube doesn't know how to make that stuff work right. If you'd like to help support the channel in a financial sense, go ahead and check out that Streamlabs donation link. Make it a point at the start of my streams to read any and all donation comments. Alright folks, well, we're basically done here for today. But for me, the effort is not over. No. Now it's the hard part. Getting my buddy Robert's figure to look better. Wish me luck.